adding that a normal person cannot absorb to the chin. But this is practice. What it is for you, it's to make it harder for you and to get emotionally ready for somebody trying to hurt you, because he's going to be swinging. See, these are going to make him swing the wild ass punches, which is good. And he's going to be hitting, he's going to try to hit you really, really hard. That's his key. Really, really hard, trying to hit you, and you're just going to shield up and arrow. An arrow and one of twos, okay? There are other things we could do later, but just from what we've learned so far, it's going to be ones and twos. So it's basically protection for him, but it's emotionally for you. You're gonna be a lot more confident after this is done or laid out on the ground. What are your two options? Survive or die. But you'll get better if you survive. So anyway. Don't just stand there as a heavy bag for them to punch on. Move too, you know, up, down, around, you know, you're not, that's what happens to you in a real fight. All these things you know, because why? Because it's not in the reptilian brain. It's in your thinking human brain. Yeah, I understand it, but that's not what works in stress. You can't do math problems either. If I start asking you, what's 5 minus 4 plus 3? What the hell? You're going to get knocked out, because that's gone. That type of functioning is gone. What's still here is, I still breathe. That's there, that's reptilian. That's reptilian, mammalian, and then the primate, forebrain, neocortex, whatever. All that stuff, but we gotta program the reptilian. That's what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be stress for you guys here. They're supposed to have fun.
It was, actually,
It should be overwhelming at first. It should be overwhelming. She should be living hell in my head. What the hell am I paying for? You know what I mean? But you come out better, because now you've been under stress. And if you can't do it under stress, there's a few ways to need to download. If you survive this, man, normal person, what are they going to do? What are they going to do? You've seen it. You survived 100 punches, and they're not going to be protected like this. You're going to hurt the living hell out of them. So, who do we got? Advantages, They go, oh, man, you have got to switch. This is hell, and you're going to get through it. Seriously, I'm telling you right now, this to you has got to be a real fight right now. You've got to switch. This is a real fight. Although I'm making the limitation, it's still a real fight for you.
idea.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, see, I let you stay out there, so you got it.
Yeah. Good.
Because so that way you're gonna learn that one line. So somewhere in your brain you think, yeah, shield sounds like a good idea, but I'm not gonna do it. You know. Yeah.
Works,
that was a good job, though, Henry.
But with like 2 days of practice, I'll have you beating guys up, you know? Because you've been through it while they're learning while doing it. But learning while doing it pays a heavy price. You know? This is learning while doing it, but, you know, controlled.
That's when people started to look again. They want to look at the guy and stand with their chin up. Man, that's an amateur mistake. You're going to get knocked out, you know. Because that's just whoever gets lucky first with the shot coming in. No, I don't do that. Fights. I'm not fighting like this ever. I've always got that.
That's what I was saying. You gotta have that. That also helps, by the way. That's another reason to have this foot, I think, is what does that do? That puts the shoulder protection. You know,
when you're teed, this shoulder is not protecting your chin. And when you do that, see that little movement? That just alone puts the shoulder there. Yeah, I'm very square. I'm doing a lot of martial arts. No, that's wrong. No, the reality, because we're gonna shoot, or we're gonna attack, or we're gonna take down, and we're also defending. We're shielding everything because we're picking when we want to, you know. Yeah. And this is defense and fight. You can use it for both. You can use this in sport fighting. It'll work. You guys can see that. You see the arrow down.
So it's a fight. It's not that difficult right here. If you've done it, we've gone through some of it, you see you can knock people out. You see how little you need for this to disorient somebody and actually make them woozy. I mean, you've seen that this is huge. Every single person in here can knock somebody out now. And it took how long?
20 minutes maximum to learn that. And you've also seen that you can survive under stress. There's no guessing. These guys were hitting you a lot with gloves on. And with some good commentary here and there. Was he from Ohio? You know? But that's good. It's all very, very good stuff. And there's more. I mean, this is a central concept. I don't want to use that word concept. It's a central way of fighting, like I said, because you're fighting behind a shield, like the Vikings. But if you let your shield go, then you're vulnerable and you're not going to make it. Protect that village right there. So, you know. No, he's got it in his mind. He's not letting that shield go. I mean, you guys can see that he's shielding like whatever you've done in your lifetime, however you want to train 10 years or 5 or 3 or 2 or 1 or 20 years, we're just changing everything in less than actual time, less than 8 hours total. You know, pretty close to 8 hours now, but 8 hours, you know, we changed 10, whatever many years of training, and you got better stuff. Imagine if you put another 8 hours in, imagine a couple of weeks into it. I'm telling you, you're going to be beating people out, so you're going to go look for fights, basically. So send me stories of what happens from that, okay? By the way, tell me what happens from that. And